Oh, hi everybody, welcome back. Today what we're going to be doing is I'm just going to check in on the Worm Cafe. Just want to check in on the position of it and whether I think I might actually move it today, move it into a bit more of a permanent shady area while it's quite hot here. Ooh, I don't know how these things get in here all the time. Okay, so there's another one, slug. There he goes. Just have a little bit of a look in here. Content moisture is feeling quite good. So this is one where I've just put the egg cartons in as well. I haven't really sort of, oh, yod leaf. Haven't really sort of put anything else in here. You can see a little cocoon down in here. You just see that one there. Always a good sign when you see cocoons. There's another one just here. Alright, so this is the second tier. So we've got some worms going about their business. It's all huddled together over in this corner here. Some more cocoons there, so that's good. Another one just up on here. So just take this second tray off, see what's down the bottom. Not too much here, there's only a couple of little worms here, so I might just pull those ones out. Just a couple in the corner. Maybe a little bit too dry for them down here, I don't want them to dry up, so I'll retrieve those ones. I'll just pop them in there. So I'm actually going to find a new location for this bin. So yeah, so I'm going to pop it here, and then I've just got my blind here, which I'll pull right down now. So that will keep off the afternoon sun. And when it gets too windy or even too hot, I'll just pull this down, and yeah, they'll be nice and comfortable in here. So I'll just pop a bucket under here, any excess sort of leachate that might come out, and I'll just I actually keep the tap off of mine, so just so I know there's continuous airflow through there, because sometimes you might turn it off and on and forget about it, and you might leave the tap off and it'll get quite anaerobic in there, because all the liquid would just be pooling in the bottom and just going really stale. That one's all in a nice new position. Sometimes you've got to move them around depending on your season, and yeah, because it's the middle of our summer here, it is actually getting quite hot, and I just don't want them to be baking out there. So I've just got one little bag of frozen small little lettuce that we had, so I'm just going to tip that into the top tier here. I thought I had some more frozen food in there, but I don't. That's all good. So I'm just going to nestle that right in there. Just going to cover that over. also having another look in my deep freezer. I've come across a bag of stewed apples. I would have put those in there for worm food. I didn't see them in there when I had looked before. So, and what I'm going to do with this one is I'm just going to leave it in the bag, and I'm just going to bury the bag open, and we'll see if the worms will make their way into there like they did with the cup and the hungry bin, to see how they're attracted to different foods, whether they will just climb in here and see if they start honing in on that. So that lettuce that I put in there earlier on sort of kind of deflated all the liquids drained out of it, and I'll tell you what, the worms have just moved straight into it as well. So what I'm going to do is kind of put it in the same area. I'm just gonna have it like that, just like that, and I'll just put a little bit of bedding in there so they kind of know they're allowed to go in there. It's not a no-go zone. Just like that. Okay, so even though it's frozen, once it starts thawing out, that'll get quite liquidy in there, so it would be interesting to see how quickly the worms are drawn into there. So I might check on that tomorrow, and we'll have a bit of an update on that one. Oh well, it's always a good idea to check and monitor where you've got your worm farms, depending on your season, and if it's really hot, always keep the worm farms in the shade, in the cool area, and in winter time if you're able to and you don't have snow, you can put them out into a nice sunny spot in the garden there, and it should warm up their little bins and keep them warm overnight. So thanks for watching, and I'd like to thank my current subscribers, new subscribers, and people passing through the channel. Thanks for your interactions and leaving your comments, it's much appreciated, and hope to see you in the next video. Okay, bye.